Big announcement during yesterday's Money Watchers Business Lunch had to do with the disclosure that at least 40 more employees have been laid off at Alex and Ani, the iconic Cranston-based jewelry and fashion accessories company. As a major driver of the Rhode Island economy, what happens at that company has an effect beyond the company itself, at least symbolically. Let's talk about that now with Mark Higgins, the Dean of the College of Business Administration at the University of Rhode Island. It's a well-followed company, at least in the publicity department, although they don't say too much about, you know, their earnings and stuff, because they don't have to.
They don't have to. They're a privately held company. They're not subject to the same rules, SEC rules, that a publicly held company are required to follow. So we know that their sales for 2013 was approximately $245 million based on the information they've released, and they expect those sales to grow in the with the opening of new stores, most recently in Annapolis.
As we disclosed yesterday during this broadcast, the 40 layoffs include, I think, at least four top-level executives. Is this unusual? Does this mean that this high-flying company may not be high-flying, or is that just too dramatic to say?
Well, I think it might be a little too dramatic. I think with Giovanni leaving, I think, and Carolyn taking control as the CEO, I think the real reason, looking back now 4 months later, is there must have been a strategic conflict between the two. The strategy that Giovanni wanted to employ was probably different than what she wanted to employ. You got to remember, when the three and a half years prior, she went out and hired Giovanni as the CEO. So it is surprising when they hired someone as a CFO and a chief operating officer back a couple of weeks ago, that they didn't hire a CEO. I think she's looking for someone who strategically fits what her vision of the company is.
Now, the Giovanni you're talking about is Giovanni Feroci, of course, the CEO who left. But before he left, he talked about them going public, issuing stock.
Right.
Do you think that's still going to happen?
No, I can't see that happening until at least they resolve who is going to be the CEO going forward. When you put together a company, you want to get complementary skill sets. I think she recognized by hiring Giovanni initially that she needed someone who was stronger in maybe strategy, maybe finance than she was. She's obviously very creative and has a flair for marketing. So I think she's looking for someone who's going to have the same vision as she has. That could be the woman they hired as chief counsel. It could be the woman they hired as the CFO. We'll just have to see how it all plays out in the coming months.
It's an interesting company to watch because they've been so successful so quickly. So we'll have to continue to monitor that and see how they develop. They have announced, too, that they're hiring people.
Exactly. And so they've hired some other people in not quite the C-suite, but at vice president's level, growing the technology side, growing the web side, growing their presence in the retail side. And they have plans to continue to grow, and they're going to release all their fall products, obviously, in September, and that'll give us a better indication of where they're headed.
And Mark Higgins, we thank you for joining us.
Great to be here. Thanks.
From URI School of Business.